Hi students, in our previous class already we discussed about mandala characters. These are seven characters in that we observed two types of traits in each character. These characters are called dominant character. Dominant characters means these are expressive characters and these are non-expressive characters, means recessive characters. Now we are going to discuss about experiment. Which experiment means monohybrid cross. In monohybrid cross, Mendel selected only one character, only one character. But in this character, it shows variations. By selecting only single character with two traits, he started his experiments. For example, just imagine in all plants he conducted experiments, but we are selecting here only one plant. What is that plant means? Here we are taking a tall plant as well as a which one? Dwarf plant. Between these two plants, he conducted an experiment. So he selected only one character, that's why. What is that one character means? Here plant height. Here he selected only plant height character and he started his hybridization experiments. In this experiment, tall is crossed with a dwarf plant. And in F1 generation, he observed that production of all tall plants. In F1 generation, he observed that production of all tall plants. So, by this, he understand that when he selected two variant forms in single character, he observed expression of only one of the trait of a parent, means tall only expressed in a F1 generation. So he concluded that tall is a dominant character. How he concluded, we will discuss now. When he conducted a cross between a tall and dwarf, he got all tall plants in which one? F1 generation. But actually, when he self-pollinated this tall plant, means F1 progeny plants, he got three are tall plants and one is a dwarf plant. Three are tall plants, one is a dwarf plant. How? We can see once here by considering which one? Allelic forms. Tall means capital D homozygous. Already he produced homozygous plants by conducting which one? Self-pollination. This capital D represent tall character. Small d represent which one? Dwarf character. This capital D can produce a capital D type of gametes and small t also produces a small d type of gametes. When these gametes fuses with each other, it has to produce which one? Capital D small t heterozygous condition consisting F1 progeny. Now, this F1 progeny, in this F1 progeny, he conducted which one? Self-pollination. Self-pollination means, here, phenotypically means whatever we see with our naked eye, that is called phenotypic character. Whatever we can't see, genetical makeup, that is called genotypic character. Whatever we see, that is a tall plant, no. So, now we are conducting here which one? Self-pollination. Here, if you see self-pollination means, this plant can able to produce two types of gametes. One is capital T type of gamete and another one is a small t type of gamete. So here he is conducting which one? Self-pollination. No. Self-pollination means both gametes are similar. Means capital T small t and capital T small t. Like this gamete formation we can expect. So here you see one is a male, another one is a female. You see here gametic fusion, capital T and capital T, capital T small t and capital T small t and small t small t. We know that here phenotypically we observed three are tall and one is a dwarf. Means we can see here capital T small t, capital T small t, capital T. These three plants are which one? Means tall plants. But a small t consisting plant is which one? A dwarf plant. So these are exist in a 3:1 ratio. Means when he conducted a self-pollination, he observed that 3:1 ratio tall and dwarf. Actually, In a F1 generation plant, what is that? Tall plant only he selected, but he observed a production of dwarf plant. Actually, he used only tall plant, but when he got dwarf plant, then he got one conclusion. What is that means? A dwarf character representing a structure or factor is present in tall plant of F1 generation, but it is not expressed in this F1 generation. So that's why he concluded that this dwarf character is suppressed by this tall character. So he given one conclusion. The character which is expressed and which is not expressed, the expressed one is termed as here dominant, and which is not expressed, that is termed as here recessive. So like this he given one conclusion. In F1 generation, tall character is expressed. So this one is termed as here dominant character, and dwarf character is not expressed, but even though it is exist in this tall. But to get clarity, to test the genotype of F1 generation plant, he conducted which one means a test cross. Now we are going to discuss about a test cross. This test cross we will discuss in our next class. Thank you.